Hi, I'm Sarah from You Floral, and today I'm going to walk you through the steps to make a wall hanging like this. Follow along and I'll tell you how easy it is to make it for your own place.
So to create our dried flower wall hanging, we need something to actually stick our dried flowers into. So you can use an Oasis pre-made cage, but I've actually made my own, and this is what I've made here. So it takes a few minutes to actually make, so I'm just going to tell you guys quickly how I make this without going fully into all the steps. So I'm actually using what's called steel strapping, and I have my tin snips, I have a piece of MDF board, and I have chicken wire and foam. So to put this all together, I'm going to take my tin snips to cut my chicken wire. I'm taking my chicken wire and wrapping it around my MDF board. I put the foam underneath it, encase the chicken foam around it, and then I take my steel strapping and I use that to attach to the backside to make my cage. So it's a lot easier, obviously, if you just buy something, but I made this one, so let's get started. I find it easier to work by putting it on the wall first. And then that way I can move back and forth and see it in the way that it's actually going to be displayed. So I've got my cage on the wall, and I'm going to start with my big elements first. So I've got this beautiful big palm here. I'm just going to cut it down a little bit here. And I'm going to place it at an angle and just shoving it into the foam. And my chicken wire helps also encase it there, so it's in there pretty firmly. And then I'm going to start filling out the other side. So you can see that it flops because of the weight, so I'm going to have to be really aware of that when I'm creating this to make sure that I have the weight evenly distributed. So I'm going to stick in some palms on the other side to provide the balance of having it going on either side. So now after I've got my palms in, I'm going to start filling it in with pampas grass. So I've got some pampas grass fluff here, and it's sometimes a little bit hard to actually stick it into the foam when it is all little pieces. So I'll take my tape here, and I'm going to actually attach the pieces together with my tape, and I'm just pulling at the floral tape to actually make it sticky. And I'm wrapping it around the bottom of my pampas grass, so that way I end up with a bit of a point that's a lot easier to shove into my foam. So there is a piece of the pampas grass there. So I'm going to shove it into the foam. And then I'm going to do that a couple other places. This one here has a nice sort of stem, so I don't need to do that sort of wrapping. And I'm just gonna keep shoving in a bunch of pampas all throughout this foam here.
So now that I've got pampas throughout my cage here, I'm going to start filling it in with some different elements. I've got my baby's breath here, and I'm going to just start placing it throughout the display to sort of provide some structure to it. I'm starting with my bigger pieces first, such as the baby's breath, and then I'm going to move into the more delicate, finer pieces of dried flowers to fill in after. On this one here, I took the baby's breath and actually wrapped some floral tape around it to get a little tight bunch. You don't have to do that, but I kind of like it to keep all the baby's breath together in a tight bundle. I've also got this yarrow that's a bit bigger as well in terms of filling up space, and so I'm going to put this throughout my cage as well to just fill in the space, because I obviously don't want to be able to see all this green floral foam. So I'm just going to keep doing that, filling in all this, some of the spaces with this kind of bigger, more voluminous greenery and dried flowers, and just keep adding it in. Now that I've got my baby's breath kind of half covering the foam here, I'm starting to add in my smaller elements, like this cool poppy. This is what really gives you the dimension and the shape to your arrangement, is adding in a bunch of different shapes. Even though they're all kind of this muted tone, by having all the different textures, that's what really elevates your design and really makes it look polished. That's the same technique as before, just kind of filling it in, making sure that we're not able to see the foam once we're completed, and just putting it in throughout my cage here. So I'm going to keep on doing that. So now I've got this filled out throughout the whole way. You've got my pampas providing some nice depth to it. Also my palms on either side giving it nice dimension. You can see now it's actually holding itself up because the weight is more evenly distributed. And I've got my center focal piece here of these super cool textures that are in the different muted tones. So that's all there is to it, guys. Hopefully you enjoyed learning how to make this dried flower hanging today, and let me know if you have any questions. Thanks for watching.